So you've just been diagnosed with prediabetes and you're wondering, what do I do now? First of all, don't panic and don't beat yourself up. You didn't develop prediabetes overnight. It didn't happen just because of your love of caramel macchiatos. In fact, it's unknown exactly what causes prediabetes. Yes, there are lifestyle factors, but there are likely genetic factors as well. The important thing to understand is that prediabetes is reversible. It's also important to understand what prediabetes is. Your blood sugar is elevated. Your doctor probably had you do a couple of different lab tests to determine this. So your blood sugar is too high, but it's not high enough to be type 2 diabetes. That's good news. You have time to course correct and prevent type 2 diabetes from happening. I probably don't need to tell you the scary statistics of how many people with prediabetes end up developing type 2 diabetes and having to go on medications and possibly even supplemental insulin. This is something that you should take seriously and address today. So I'm going to take you through the first three things you need to do to reverse this condition, starting now. Number one, get control of the carbohydrates in your diet. Carbohydrates are the primary macronutrient that drives the creation of glucose. Now, you can do this a couple of different ways. First, you can begin decreasing the high carbohydrate foods that you're consuming. Yes, highly processed foods like donuts, muffins, candy, soda are absolutely going to cause your blood sugar to spike. But where it gets more complicated are the foods that are seemingly healthy. Foods like dried fruit, potatoes, even vegetables like corn. So you can start by limiting sugary and starchy foods. And maybe you'll go back to your doctor in a few months for a follow-up test of your blood sugar to see how things have changed. That's a great first step. But if you've already tried that and your labs haven't improved, or if you want to get more serious, then you need to really consider tracking your blood sugar. And this can be done easily with just a couple of simple tools. Tracking your blood sugar is going to help you understand which specific foods are raising your blood sugar. Because why would you stop eating all the foods that you love before knowing which ones are really the problem? Now, there are two easy tools to do this. The first is a glucometer, which you can buy off Amazon for about $30, or you can use a continuous glucose monitor, also called a CGM. Now, you might be thinking, aren't those tools used by people who have diabetes? And the answer is yes, they are, but you can use them too. And in fact, more and more doctors are figuring this out as a way to help their patients reverse prediabetes and prevent getting type 2 diabetes. So if you're interested in using either of these tools, I highly recommend you check out my other videos on these exact topics where I discuss in detail how to use either tool. Okay, step number two to reverse prediabetes, add a little exercise to your life. So here's the thing. When you consume food and it gets converted into glucose, sugar, one of two things is going to happen to that sugar. It's either going to sit around in your bloodstream, or it's going to be converted and transported to your cells as fuel and utilized as energy. So the more you can burn up that fuel that you've consumed, the less it's going to be sitting around. A bonus here is that the act of exercising also helps to improve how effectively your body handles glucose in the future. This is called insulin sensitivity. So imagine your cells are behind a locked door. Insulin is a hormone that is the key that unlocks the door and allows the glucose to enter your cells. You want this to happen. You don't want the glucose hanging out in your bloodstream. You want it to go into your cells. So exercise over time helps improve the effectiveness of insulin. So what can you start doing right now, today? Start by walking 20 minutes a day. Ideally, try to walk for about 5 to 10 minutes after each meal. But even if you can't, and you can walk around your neighborhood for 20 minutes in the morning or evening or on your lunch break, that will help with balancing your blood sugar. Lastly, step number three to start right away is to take a hard look at your stress levels. Now, you might be thinking, stress? What does that have to do with my blood sugar? Well, a lot, actually. how the body responds to stress is with the hormones cortisol and adrenaline, and both of these hormones cause an increase in glucose. The glucose doesn't come from food, it comes from a stored version in your liver called glycogen. So what happens is this: you get stressed, your body secretes cortisol and/or adrenaline, and this triggers the release of glycogen from your liver, and glycogen turns into glucose. But this glucose can have the same effect on blood sugar as if you've eaten food, such as cookies. So that's why I like to call these stress cookies, because they affect your body in the same way as if you've eaten a cookie. So what to do about this? Assess your level of stress on a daily basis. On a scale of 1 to 10, 1 being not stressed at all and 10 being extremely stressed, what level do you hit on most days? If it's above 5, then you need to determine ways to counteract that stress, or what I call stress antidotes. These should be things other than exercise, things that are really, truly enjoyable and rejuvenating. It could be reading a great book, painting or other art, meditation, deep breathing, etc. Here's a good rule to follow. For the amount of time that you're stressed at a level 5 or above each day, you should counteract that with the same amount of time doing something rejuvenating. Now, notice that the last two things I just told you about don't involve changing your diet. In fact, there are quite a few things you can do to improve blood sugar without changing your diet. If you're interested in these, check out my free email course called 10 Ways to Improve Your Blood Sugar Without Changing Your Diet. The link is down below. So, in summary, you're in a great position to alter the course of your health right now. Start with a close look at carbohydrates, exercise, and stress. And if you like this video, be sure to hit the subscribe button, and I'll see you next time.